This is part 7 of a series on gradient boosting method. In this video, we will look at the multi-class classification problem. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice was generated through AI, text-to-speech. In the last video, we followed the GBM algorithm step by step and implemented binary classification with code. In this video, we will implement GBM's multi-class classification in code. Let's look at the data with multiple classes as shown below. There are two features, X and a target class Y, which consists of 0, 1, and 2. If there are more than two classes, convert the target Y to one hot encoding. Class 0 is converted to 1, 0, 0. And class 2 is converted to 0, 0, 1. The first column represents the probability that Y is 0. And the second column represents the probability that Y is 1. We now separate this data into three data sets as shown on the right. Since each data set has classes 0 and 1, the binary classification is possible. For each data set, a GBM model is created and the binary classification is performed. Then, we can get three prediction results from each model. At each iteration, we use the softmax function to normalize each predicted probability, calculate the residuals, and use these residuals to create new models in the next iteration. In this way, if the number of classes is 3, then 3 models are also created. And in the next iteration, another 3 models are created. The total number of models generated is the number of iterations m multiplied by the number of classes. And in the prediction stage, the class with the highest softmax probability is selected as the final estimate. The detailed process will be covered in the code on the next page. Let's use Decision Tree Regressor and Gradient Boosting Classifier to implement multi-class classification of GBM. You can easily implement this using the Gradient Boosting Classifier. But let's use the Decision Tree Regressor to understand how the algorithm works in more detail. And let's compare the two results. This code is almost similar to the binary classification code seen in the last video. This is an extension of binary classification code to multi-class classification. The data we will use is like this. It is two-dimensional data with two features X, and it consists of three clusters. There are three classes of Y, 0, 1, and 2. We generated 300 pieces of this data. Convert Y with three classes to one hot encoding. And we define a function to convert log odds F to probability as we did in the previous video. This is a logistic function. Then we define the softmax function. The depth of the tree is set to 2, the number of trees is set to 30. And the learning rate is set to 0.1. The U class is 0, 1, and 2. Step 1 initializes the log odds F0. When Y is like this, the one hot encoding is like this. And the initial log odds F0 is calculated using this formula. Calculate the initial log odds F0 for each column in one hot encoding. Let Y hat be the average value for each column in one hot encoding. F0 is a vector like this. Next, we use F0 to initialize log odds FM, which will be updated during the iteration. Duplicate F0 down to create a two-dimensional structure like this. Then the shape of FM becomes the number of data points and the number of classes. Now repeat the process below 30 times. Step A in step 2 calculates the residuals. Use the logistic function to convert log odds FM to probabilities. And then convert this to softmax probability. This is the predicted probability, y hat. We then use the difference between the one hot encoded y and the y hat to calculate the residuals. Then the shape of the residual will also look like this. Step B in step 2 generates a regression tree and fits this tree to the residuals calculated above. Then, we read the class from UClass one by one. Build a model using DecisionTreeRegressor. And fit that model to the feature X and the corresponding column vector of the residuals. This results in a total of 3 decision trees per iteration. This means that one tree model is created for each column in one hot encoding. The total number of trees is the number of classes multiplied by the number of iterations. In step C of step 2, the gamma is calculated. We then find the leaf node ID for each tree, as we did in the previous video. And read each tree's leaf node ID one by one. To calculate the leaf value, gamma. Find the data points belonging to leaf node J. And use the residuals and Y hat to calculate the gamma with this formula. The shape of the residuals and y-hat is also like this. Find the data points belonging to leaf node J for each column. And calculate their gamma. And step D of step 2 uses this gamma. To update the log odds FM value at that location. And replace the value of each leaf node with the gamma value. The intention is to return this gamma value when calling the predict function later. And store each tree model in a models list. The GB model is a list of trees and its size is the number of classes. And the GB models list look like this. Calculate the loss function to check if training went well. Here, the loss is across entropy. After iteration up to this point, we check the loss history visually. Step 3 is the prediction stage. We randomly generated 1000 test data points. In the prediction step, logOddsFM, which will be updated through iterations, is initialized to the initial logOddsF0 for the training data. And then we read the models one by one from the GB models list. This model has as many trees as the number of classes. We get these trees one by one. We then input test data into each tree to estimate the gamma. The gamma, which is the leaf value stored in the leaf node during the training stage, is output. Multiply this by the learning rate to get the logOddsFM value. At the end of the iteration, we use the logistic function to convert logOddsFM to a probability value. Next, we convert this to a softmax probability. The shape of the Y prob and the Y soft look like this. Finally, find the class with the highest probability value. For example, if this probability is highest, class 1 is selected as the final prediction. This is YPred, the predicted class of the test data. Now let's check the results by visualizing the training data, test data, and the prediction classes. This time, let's try the gradient boosting classifier library. This library automatically works multi-class classification if the target Y has more than two classes. Fit this model with training data X and Y, and predict the target class of the test data. This library makes it very easy to implement multi-class classification. Now, let's check the prediction results. The results are like this. The picture above is the result of decision tree regressor. And the picture below is the result of gradient boosting classifier. Yellow is the training data. And red, blue, and green are the test data. The red area is where Y is 0. The blue area is where Y is 1, and the green area is where Y is 2. The decision boundary looks like this. In the results below, the decision boundary also looks like this. You can see that the two results are similar, although they are not exactly the same. And you can also see that the cross-entropy loss decreases well as the repetition progresses. Now let's check out the base model of gradient boosting classifier. The total number of trees is 30 times 3. 30 is the number of iterations, and 3 is the number of classes. If you look at the first base model, you will see that it consists of 3 decision tree regressors. Let's run this code. The results came out like this. The loss is well reduced, and the decision boundary looks like this. Let's also check out the base model of this model. The shape of the model is 30 times 3. And the first base model consists of 3 decision tree regressors. So far, we've looked at all of the gradient boosting method through a total of 7 videos.